So far we have discussed in the previous episode, you have also seen that, you must see that if you have not seen that, I have discussed about the inheritance, which is the reusability concept. In that concept, we are using that the existing class property to create a new class. Now today's concept will be the types of inheritance. That means the functions of inheritance, or how many kinds of inheritance can be there. That means in how many methods we can inherit a new class from a or multiple number of existing classes. So the first one will be single inheritance, the second one will be multiple inheritance, the third one will be multi-level inheritance, the fourth one will be hierarchical inheritance, and of course the last one will be hybrid inheritance. Okay, the first one needs single inheritance. Of course, from the name we can clearly guess one thing, that there should be only one thing. That one thing, that means there should be one base class and one child class only. That means if there is one base class, and from that one base class, if we inherit some or all of the properties of that base class, addition to that we can add some another features to create a new class, to create only one class, that will be known as single inheritance. If I will put it in a diagram, I also show you to in the diagram, and I want to add one more thing here. We would use the keyword extends, what I have said it earlier, to derive one thing. I have to write first the parent child class, after that I have to write extends, then the parent class. Okay,
is the definition and the diagram I can show to you with the single inheritance. When one subclass is inherits from one only superclass or base class is known as single inheritance. When one class is derived from any one of the superclass, that is known as single inheritance. Here A is the superclass and B here is the subclass that is derived from the A, which means that the B has some or all of the properties of A, as well as it may or may not have some of the unique features. Addition to that, I can write it with the child class first, that means B, then the key extend keyword, then after that the parent class, that is A. So the syntax will be B extends, so I can say that the B extends A. Okay,
so the second one is multiple inheritance. So in the single inheritance we have only single one thing, that means we have single base class and single child class. But in multiple inheritance, there will be multiple. Multiple in which case? Multiple in base class. That means when one class is being derived from two base classes, that means some features of one class and some features of one class will get together to create a new class, that will be known as multiple inheritance. So in one line, if I'll say it, then it will be like this. In multiple inheritance, when there is more than one base classes are there and it inherits one of the child class, that is known as multiple inheritance.
So the diagram and definition could be like this. When a subclass inherits more than one superclass of base class, it is known as multiple inheritance. Here you can clearly see there is two superclasses A and B, and both A and B gives one subclass, that is C. So I can write C extends A comma B. That means there will be the child class, then the extend keyword, and then the number of base classes, that is 2, A and B. So the syntax will be C extends A comma B.
Third one is multi-level inheritance. Name is multi-level. I'm just giving a clear example of that from your home. Grandparents, then the parents, then you. That means the parents of yours has been inherited from your grandparents and you are being inherited from your parents. That means here one intermediate subclass, that is your parent, acts as a base class for you, that means for your child, but it is a child class for your grandparents. That means multi-level means here level by level the inheritance work is been done. If A is a superclass, and then the class B is inherited from that A, and a class C is inherited from B. That means the B will contain all of the properties of A, and then the C will contain all of the properties of B as well as of A. This concept is known as multi-level inheritance. Are you getting me? And I'm again repeating it. If A is a superclass, then B is a child class. That means the B is being inherited from A as it contains all of the properties of A. And the B inherits another class that is known as C. So the C will contain all of the properties as well as of A and as well as of B. So the syntax will be like this. The B extends A, then C extends B. Okay?
So here it is, the multi-level inheritance. When a subclass inherits from a superclass which itself inherited from another superclass, then such inheritance is known as multi-level inheritance. Here A is a superclass and B is a subclass, but is superclass for the next subclass, that is the C. So A inherits B and the B inherits C. Okay, so the class B inherits all the properties of class A and the C inherits the properties of class B as well as the properties of class A. This is multi-level inheritance.
There is hierarchical inheritance. So I have discussed earlier about multiple inheritance in which there is multiple base classes and it provides one child class. So it is just opposite of that. That means here multiple child classes are being derived from one base classes. Here multiple child classes are being derived from one base classes, like a tree structure, the branches. So if I take A as a base class, then B and C both will be inherited from A. So one base class and multiple number of child classes. I can write B, C extends A. So in multiple in hierarchical inheritance, there is multiple number of child classes that is inherited from one base class.
So here is hierarchical inheritance. When one or more than one subclasses are inherited from one superclass or base class is known as hierarchical inheritance. Here A is a superclass and B and C are being derived from A. So B and C will inherit all of the properties of class A. I can write B, C extends A.
So the last one is being hybrid inheritance. So in general, hybrid means the combination of more than one is known as a hybrid. So here, combination of more than one means the combination of more than one inheritance. So actually, hybrid inheritance is a combination of multi-level and multiple inheritance. I'm repeating, hybrid inheritance is a combination of both multi-level and multiple inheritance. I'm just thinking of a diagram. A is the superclass and B are NC is being derived from A. So this has been an example of a multi-level inheritance. Then again, B and C acts as a superclass for another class D. So B and C gives another class D, which is an example of multiple inheritance, though it is been having more than one base class to derive one child class. So this has been the example, and I'll show you the diagram how the multi-level and the multiple combiningly give us the hybrid inheritance.
So here being is hybrid inheritance. So hybrid inheritance is a combination of multi-level and multiple inheritance. Here you can clearly see A is a superclass which gives B and C as the child class, and the B and C acts as a superclass for the D. So actually the thing is, the B and C will inherit the property of class A, as well as though the D is being derived from B and C, the D will also inherit the properties of B and C and also the A.